This is Keith's solution to Walter Lewin's problem 212, and in it we're wanting to send a spacecraft from the Earth to Mars, and we're doing it through an elliptical orbit, like that. Okay, lecture 22 of his 801 series is where we need to go, and also take a look, if you look in the description you'll find a link to some notes on Kepler orbit. Very useful, virtually tells you how to do the problem. Don't forget the various links to his lectures, there's some good stuff in there. Okay, so we learn from lecture 22 about the total mechanical energy of an orbit, which is given by this expression here, which must equal the kinetic energy plus the gravitational potential energy. And note, as always, gravitational potential energy is negative. So for a bound orbit, our total mechanical energy will be negative as well. Okay, and also period we learn is given by this expression here, where A, in each case, A is the semi-major axis of the ellipse. In the case of a circle, the A will simply be the radius of the circle. So for our spacecraft, this distance is crucial. We need to know it, and it's simply Re plus Rm, radius of the two orbits of Earth and Mars, and we need the semi-major axis, not the major axis, so we take the average, we take half, and it's this value here. Okay, and that's what we will use later on in the problem. Right, so from our equation for total orbital energy, which is this value here, I can rearrange this equation to get that, which will give me the velocity at any point. Come back to this. The velocity at any point in our travels related to the distance we are from the Sun. Okay, so to work out the velocity of Earth, I can simply plug in Re into both those values, and I get this expression, which leads to that value for the speed that the Earth is doing. Similarly for Mars, I get that. I'm just using Rm instead of Re. I get that value there. So we now know the speeds of the two planets. We now want to know the speed of the spacecraft, again using this expression that we've found. I can say the velocity of the spacecraft at its position at Earth must be this value here, where R0 is Re and A is the value for our elliptical orbit, our elliptical path. It turns out to be this expression. So our relative speed, one to the other, is simply VSE minus VE, and it turns out to be about 10,500 kilometers per hour. I do a similar thing for Mars, and I find that when we're at the distance Mars is from the Sun, I can feed in this, I have this expression here, and I get that we are doing this speed here. That's the speed that the spacecraft is doing. So our relative speed compared to Mars is going to be one minus the other, excuse me, and I get this value here, which is about 9,500 kilometers per hour. And note it's negative, and what that means is, and it does make sense, it caught me out first time round, but it does make sense. We start here and we give ourselves 10,500 kilometers per hour extra, which launches us into this orbit, and we start slowing down, slowing down, slowing down, slowing down, until we're doing our doing somewhat less than we were. But Mars, which needs to start around here, given it's got about 680 days to do the whole way around, is starting to catch us up. So now Mars is going faster than we are, and we need to give ourselves another additional push in the same direction we're going to establish a Martian orbit. So it's, in some ways it's quite weird that we push ourselves forwards from our point of view twice. At this point we're taking off, and at that point we're landing, but we're actually, from the view of the spacecraft, giving ourselves a push in the same direction each time. Sorry, I hope I haven't confused you there. Right, and finally, we want to know the journey time. So we use this expression here. The journey time is going to be half our elliptical orbit, because we're going from perihelion to aphelion, so it is going to be symmetrical. So half our journey time, rearrange that, we get this, and it comes out to 259 days. Thank you.